Welcome everybody. You're watching Mr. Fugu Data Science. This is going to be really interesting and useful. I had a viewer contact me and said that they wanted to see something very specific, and that's the purpose of this video today. We're using MongoDB to update nested fields within multiple documents, as well as single documents. As always, thank you to the recent subscribers and viewers. I greatly appreciate it. Feel free to get a hold of me on Twitter and Instagram. If you would like, help support this channel, hit me up right here. Let's get into this. If you've never used PyMongo, I'll leave a card above so you can look at that first. Otherwise, let's get into this. Here's your imports, as well as here's the file that we're going to use right here. It's made up. We have two customers that we're going to use. Here's one of them. Here's some of their address details. Here's some stakeholder information, and then different departments relative to that, as well as various information that's held within these. If you notice, you have a lot of empty data because let's just assume that this is a new database that you're starting in Mongo. You also have values here that are empty strings. And we also have what we're interested in today, which is right here highlighted. This is going to be our requirements documents that we're going to populate each one of these 17 keys that have empty values. Since these are currently empty strings, we approach this a little different for updating the information opposed to if it was already populated. That's something you should be aware of first. Here's the second person or customer that we have, similar information. I threw this into a data frame and saved it as a JSON file so everyone could be on par and use the same data, and feel free to update this or make it even more nested to play around with it and get more experience. We're using a CSV file which will have our requirement documents stored as key value pairs, which will be used to update our file. Notice that I have underscore for each of the names that are more than one word. This will help you so you don't have errors later when you're trying to actually do updates or actual queries. So that's just a little tip. Here's what we're starting with initially for one of our entries. The requirements text is our CSV file that we're going to use, which looks like this with our 17 columns that we can scroll over and multiple entries. And you'll say, well, I have more than two rows, but I only have two entries. That's fine, because we're just going to subset this and play around with it. All right. So this requisite is what I would say pay attention to, and whoever is the owner by one of these names, since we're going to use these for, I think I use Jojo and Depeche for our subset data. So you'll have a NaN and you'll have a 2. That'll help us keep track so you can visually see what's going on. I converted this into a dictionary so to be able to send off to MongoDB directly. We make our connection call. I do not have a dedicated server, so I'm using the general local host. I don't have a database, so I'm creating a database on the fly as well as my collection here. The file that we saved beforehand for the Mongo fields, I'm calling that in now, converting it into a dictionary, inserting many, underscore many. Then we have our file sent. We can query real quick and see the first entry, which is this. I'm going to save this real quick because this is going to be useful for the second example. We have our first customer, all their information. We scroll down, see a bunch of empty lists. We see some empty strings. And then we get to what we're really interested in, which is this right here. This right here. Therefore, as a side note, I want to mention we're updating specific fields. These are nested, and we need the dot notation outer to enter. I need to make that very clear. You're going to notice something. You may get an error if you're not updating properly, and I'll express that in a second. Here's the first update that we're going to do. We're doing this one by one, replacing our key value pairs. I decided to subset like this just because, for no particular reason, to have fun. Remember, the first one, the requisite, is going to be NaN. Then the owner is going to be Jojo Watts. The second one, requisite, is going to be 2. And the owner is Depeche. Then, let's get into this really quick. Let's see what's going on when I'm actually iterating through this. I put example 2 because this ordering was different beforehand. But you'll just see this is what we're dealing with currently. This is what we're going to fill in. We're iterating twice because we're dealing with key value pairs. So we're converting this into tuples so we can place this in to MongoDB. Notice, let's scroll in just a little bit. Make this clear. We're iterating inside. We're taking our key value pairs. This right here is very important because we're letting Mongo say, hey, we're trying to match this particular field. We're doing the dot notation, and then we're calling in the first entry for our tuples, which is coming from here, from our list that we iterated inside of, and we have this empty string because none of our values have any population. They're all empty. So you need to let Mongo know, hey, this is original data that we're going to deal with, and this is what we're replacing the values with. You're using the set operator with the dollar sign here, a little different than if you're using the terminal or shell. Pay attention to this. You have the requirement document dot, then the dollar operator or dollar sign, then the dot, and then each one of the iterated columns that you're going inside of the nesting, and then the value for that key. So let's back up and say this one more time. We iterate inside of our list of key value pairs. Then I used one instead of many because I was getting a weird kind of an error. Then we're taking the original data that we're trying to manipulate for our key, which is nested. So we do the dot notation, and then this entry that we're iterating through, we have no values, so it's empty strings. We're replacing everything with this. We can scroll out just a little bit so we can actually see this. And we're printing it off and saying, all right, this is what we're actually dealing with. So I need to copy this for later. So this is what we're going to use for later. So copy this. We have the first owner as Jojo Watts. We have their requisite as Nan. We have the second one as requisite 2. And its owner is Depesh right here. So it went through perfectly and we updated our information. I had you memorize those two because those are the easiest fields to remember. The next thing we're doing is the same kind of rigmarole, but it's with one document. In order to do that and be specific, you don't want to just update the first document that comes up in MongoDB, unless that's what you want to do. Instead, you use a specific ID and then you'll take its object ID information. And that's really important. So you map everything to the specific location it needs to go. You'll also need to do this from bison.objectid import object ID so you can actually call this information properly within Mongo. Don't forget you need to import this, okay? We're going to move on and say, let's take our new object ID, cut and paste it in here. And what did I do? I iterated through this. I ran my query with this specific object ID because this is what we're going to want to update. Since we don't have empty strings for these values now, like these, we need to actually call these into Mongo. So I created a list, and you'll see that it's a list of dictionaries. We're going to take that list, and what are we going to do? We're going to go inside of this because it's a list, take the specific requirement document, go inside of that again, and get all of its values. And that's what we're going to use to map everything. So we're going to, for instance, call this from our original document that we made in the beginning, and we're going to map a different value, which is going to be requisite 1. And this person who owns this is different. It's going to be nobody who owns this, which is interesting, but that's what we're going to use to change this up a little bit. So let's scroll down, and let's update this. And it's the same exact information we did above for our first example, except here, instead of empty string, we have to iterate with I for our values that we stored as a list. And then now we're going inside this list of dictionaries, which is nested, and calling the values, iterating through it, and plucking that here. So Mongo knows what our original requirement document field is for each of our list of dictionaries, and then what we're replacing it with. We iterate through that. Now I need to change this, since this is our new one, and we'll scroll down. And we'll notice that we have a new requisite ID, which was changed, and our owner, which is our Nan. Nobody owns this here. And let's print this off as a data frame so we could verify that now we have it. Instead, this originally was a Nan. It became a 1, and it changed for our owner. So we, in fact, updated our information. So the gist of this, you could go and change individual fields, multiple fields, one document, multiple documents, which are nested. That's the purpose of this video. Please like, share, and subscribe. And if you subscribe, turn on that notification bell. I hope this brought utility to somebody. Feel free to hit me up on Instagram and Twitter. And if you thought this was useful, please consider helping support this channel and buy me a coffee. I'll see you in the next video. Thanks for watching. Bye.